Hi, I'm Jacob Ohnesorge. I was a four-year starter here at SDSU and won the Remington Award for the top center of all of college football. Join me on another episode of A Decade of Excellence.
He'll air it up, right side for Goddard, leaping one-hand grab!
Patel, one-on-one with Ohm, overhand,
back down out of bounds. Squeeze is on, the bunt is down, the throw home is late!
Here we are in Dan J. Dykhouse Stadium, home of Jackrabbit football. In September of 2016, this place opened with quite the bash. Luke Bryan, Lil Big Town, and Lee Bryce all took the stage for what we called the Jacks Bash. Over 25,000 people turned out to christen our beautiful new home. Two nights later, we played our first football game here, a 56-28 win over Drake behind five Taryn Christian touchdowns. That football team was special. We earned a top 8 seed in the FCS playoffs, a program first. Taryn was the Missouri Valley Football Conference Offensive Player of the Year as a sophomore. He was one of four of us to become All-Americans. Wide receiver Jake Winicky, tight end Dallas Goddard, and myself were equally honored. Winicky and Nick Mears were also academic All-Americans. In fact, we were the Missouri Valley Football Conference champions, and that fall, there were plenty of other banners hung around campus. Rodney Haven was Coach of the Year as men's cross country steamrolled to another Summit League title. Six of the top 10 finishers were Jacks, led by Joel Reichow. He would finish 20th at the NCAA Championships in November, earning All-America for the second straight year. On the women's side, Emily Donne was the Summit League Athlete of the Year and Championship MVP, winning the conference race. Soccer won the Summit League Tournament for the third consecutive season, but it wasn't without drama. Both the semifinal win over IUPUI and the championship victory over Oral Roberts went to penalty kicks. Let's move indoors. Women's basketball is led by the Conference Defensive Player of the Year, Clarissa Ober, who finished second in school history with 174 block shots. Sophomore Mike Dumm won the Summit League Player of the Year as the men got hot at the right time. In danger of not making the conference tournament in late January, they won the league's postseason event to return to the NCAA tournament. And while they beat Omaha in the championship, everyone remembers Michael Orris' shot to win in the semifinals over USD.
10 seconds left, Jacks down one. Orris into the front court, 7 seconds left, 5 left. Orris left wing, 3 seconds left, 18-footer, good! With 1 4/10 of a second left, and a timeout to the Coyotes! Michael Orris!
5 wrestlers made it to St. Louis in the NCAA championships. Seth Gross took second at the 133 pounds, while Alex Kocher finished 8th at 149. Each were All-Americans. Swimmer Weston Christensen was an academic All-American, posting a 3.94 GPA in civil engineering. The track and field teams won a grand total of 15 events at the conference meets. Joel Reichow was the Men's Indoor Athlete of the Year, winning both the mile and the 5,000 meter. Rachel King earned Women's Indoor Athlete of the Year by winning both the 3,000 and 5,000 meters. Then Kyle Burdick won the Summit's Outdoor Athlete of the Year by virtue of his wins in the 1,500 and 10,000 meter races. He would go on to earn All-American honors in the outdoor. Brian Quarter won both the indoor and outdoor long jump, plus the triple jump. Alejandro Sanchez took the 800 meter title, both indoor and outdoor. And Rod DeHaven won his second coach of the year, this one for men's track and field. Men's golf repeated as Summit League champions, with Casey Van Dam being honored as coach of the year. And Megan Mingo was the conference women's golfer of the year, establishing a new record for scoring average while winning the league meet. And baseball's Luke Ringhofer was a 22nd round draft pick of the Baltimore Orioles. The catcher ranked 3rd in walks with 114 before leaving following his junior year to pursue his professional dreams. Whew, what a year. And in case you missed anything, here's another look at the numbers. We brought home the Summit League Men's All Sports Trophy, 9 All-Americans, 3 Academic All-Americans, 9 Conference Player of the Year awards, 6 conference titles, 261 Academic All-League honorees, 93 All-Conference athletes, and a cumulative grade point average of 3.299. So there you have it, one of the best years in school history, but there's more where that came from. Stay tuned for another installment, and remember, go big, go blue, go Jacks.